Welcome students to another lecture of social science. In previous few lectures we were discussing, we were learning geography's few chapters. Yesterday I uploaded a video which is which will be helpful to you for quick revision of resource chapter. Before that I also uploaded two videos that were based on water resources, and today we will start another subject of social science, that is economics. In economics, first chapter already we have discussed, and today in this lecture we will discuss the second chapter of economics, that is the sectors of Indian economy. Economy is a subject where all the things which we will be discussed concern to Indian economy, the activities of people, GDP, and so many factors which are associated to economic activities of human being. As these various sectors of Indian economy are there, and we need to see those various sectors of Indian economy. Let us see exactly what is this sector and how it is essential. Okay, economic activities are classified into groups using some important criteria. These groups are known as sectors or economy. In day-to-day life, every person, every individual has to perform some activities to fulfill his own needs, his family's needs, and so we can say that people around us, everyone is busy in some or other work. Somebody is going in field to one, working on daily wages basis. Some people they are working in shops. Some people they have their own vehicles, their transportation. Some people they are doctors and engineers and teachers. Some people have their own factories, some people are working in factories, some people have their shops. So if we make a list of all these activities, the list will be in thousands. Number in that list will be in thousands. So here we need to classify, we need to categorize those activities for scientific study or say proper study or proper planning of this. Okay? So this generally economic sectors in India we have divided into three different types: the primary sector, the secondary sector, and tertiary sectors. Here we can see various activities that I told you: the shopkeeper, the farmer, the person who is carrying the loads. Okay. Here some other sectors are there, people are of urbanized sectors, they are working, and all these people we need to study them properly as per their sectors. Let us see here. This classification of sectors on the basis of nature or activities. And accordingly, we can divide into sectors into three major types: the primary sector, the secondary sector, and tertiary sector. Students, you have already studied the sectors of economy or sectors of people, those who are busy in various sectors, various fields. Now, what is primary sector? Primary sector is all activities. Listen carefully. All activities performed by human being based on nature are known as primary sector. See, there are various activities. For example, we have seen a picture of a farmer, or we have seen a fisherman, or we have seen animal husbandry, or some other activities, food gathering from forest and wood cutting. See, if you see all these activities are directly dependent on nature. So the activities which depend on nature are known as primary sectors or primary sectors activities. See, its definition: the economic activities which are connected with extraction and production of natural resources, for example agriculture, fishing, mining, etc. In some book, mining is been included in secondary activity also, because some types of processing are needed in mining. In recent books, you will see that it has added in secondary activities also. But again, let me complete this, that primary activities means activities which based on, which depend on the nature. Now, what is secondary activities? Now, secondary activities is a little different. Here, generally comes manufacturing field over here. Manufacturing field. Some processes is been done in this field. It's known as secondary activities. Or we can define in a little different way, that activities which depend on the goods come from primary sector are known as secondary activity. Let me explain you with example. Sugar industry is example of secondary activity. Sugar industry is example of secondary activity. Now, what is the raw material for sugar industry? That is sugar cane. And sugar cane comes from the product or the raw material for secondary activity comes from primary activity. In cotton industry, cotton textile industry, raw material is cotton, which comes from agriculture or from mineral industry. In mineral industry, okay, or steel industry is part of secondary activity, but the raw material, that the iron ore which is required for this industry, comes from primary industry. So secondary industry is a processing industry for which raw material which required it comes from primary industry, like secondary industry. Some example, its definition over here: the economic activities which are related to the manufacturing process. For example, manufacturing of steel and all, it falls under secondary sectors. As already I told you some other examples of this too. And apart from these two, one more economic activity is there, that is a tertiary sector. It's after primary and secondary, it's a tertiary sector. In tertiary sector, there is no direct production you will find. This is not concerned to production, but this activity, it is helpful for previous two activities, that is primary and secondary activity. For example, transportation comes in tertiary activities. Now, what is transportation? What type of things being transported? In transportation, there is a transportation of raw material from agriculture field to industries, and the finished goods which comes from industry, that is transported again from that industry to the marketplace. And these two things, that is, they are connected by this tertiary sector. So the tertiary sector, which is helpful for primary sector and secondary sectors. And in tertiary sectors, we can have some examples. For example, transport is one example of tertiary sector. Then communication is another example of this sector. Then trade is another example of this sector. And some other sectors. For example, services also a part of tertiary sector. For example, a doctor, then a teacher, then lawyer, and then engineer. They are providing various services. And these services also a part of a tertiary sector. Let us see here, with the help of this slide, I will explain you in detail the economic activities that are mostly based on providing service to the society, like transportation, banking, insurance, etc., comes under tertiary sector. So these three are the major sectors of economy, that is a primary sector, secondary sector, tertiary sector. Now let us move this. Then what is gross domestic product? We are this after these sectors, the next point which we have to discuss, that is a gross domestic product, that is GDP. You must be listening this word very first time, but this is a term that is very important in economics, and now henceforth you will study, you will listen this word again and again. Might have heard GDP of India is going down, or GDP of India is progressing rapidly. Then many times we are confused, what is this GDP? Okay, GDP is long form. You might be knowing that GDP means gross domestic product, but what is actually GDP, or what is gross domestic product? Okay, see, it's defined here: the value of final goods and services produced in each sector during a particular year provides the total production of the sector for that year, and the sum of production in the three sectors gives GDP, that is gross domestic product of the country. Now here, this word is very, very important. Value of final goods and services comes from all three sectors. Now each goods has its value. Okay, this pencil has its value. The chalk has its value. In like this way, everything has its value. But as from primary sector, that thing is in the form of raw material. Then when it goes from raw material to finished material in industrial sector, it is being polished and it is modified. We call this modified thing a finished good. When that finished good comes in market, again some transportation cost and all the other costs are added. And when that good, that is ready to use, okay, that final cost is known as its final value. And likewise, listen carefully, the value of all three sectors, the complete value of all three sectors, that is a primary activities, secondary activities and tertiary activities, in one financial year, the total value of all this, it's known as GDP. I repeat, it's the the sum and the sum of a production in three sectors give the gross domestic product of country. A GDP shows how big the economy of country. Many times it is considered that if GDP it goes in two digit, that GDP it goes in two digit GDP rate, it is beneficial for the country. So we will have a pause over here, and tomorrow we will continue comparing these activities with each other. Thank you for today.